The white-tailed deer. For many Mississippi hunters, the pursuit of this animal can almost become an obsession, leading them to great lengths and heights to avoid detection while in the woods. Unfortunately, the thrill of the hunt that drives so many sportsmen can turn to tragedy in a matter of seconds if the wrong decisions are made.
The number of people that hunt from elevated stands has increased in the last 25 years drastically, and so that it does lead to more chances to have an incident with a tree stand.
The increase of deer hunting accidents this year alone in Mississippi has put the subject in the headlines, with several falls resulting in death. As state law requires that all hunting-related incidents be investigated by the Mississippi Department of Wildlife, Fisheries, and Parks, Lieutenant Clark McMinn has seen just about every accident scenario possible. He says the most common accidents involve homemade ladder stands that are often built with non-treated lumber.
You should check it each step. Pull on it and make sure before you put your weight on the next step, you check the step above you if you're going up a homemade ladder stand. People still go out into the woods, build a homemade tree stand, and don't check it, and don't go back 2 or 3 years later and try to climb up in it, and the wood's rotten, the nails pull out, and a lot of accidents happen that way.
Also on the rise are the number of accidents involving manufactured climbing stands. Most of these could be prevented, however, if hunters would simply safety inspect the bolts and cables on their equipment before entering the woods and follow proper operational guidelines when it comes to climbing a tree.
Making sure your pins are all in working order, not broken, bent, or missing, rusty cables. This cable, that's what keeps you tied to the tree. So if you're sitting here and that breaks, this is gonna come out and there's nothing else holding you to the tree.
You want to make sure the tree is big enough to support your weight and the weight of all your gear and your stand. Some people tend to, you know, if they want a certain spot, they may try to use a tree that's a little small. This tree would not be one that I would typically pick out for two or three reasons. One, it's got an extremely hard bark. It's a hardwood tree, extremely hard bark, which would, using a climbing stand, would make it hard for your stand to get a good bite into the bark.
Taking the time to properly inspect a climbing stand and also scout a hunting area for a safe tree to climb are both very important safety measures, but there is one precaution that's by far more critical than anything else. Regrettably, it's also the one thing many hunters fail to do.
I would not go into a tree stand, homemade or factory built, without using a good safety harness at all times.
Lieutenant McMinn says that no hunter has ever been the victim of a life-threatening accident while wearing a full-body safety harness, such as the one seen here. Despite this fact, studies show that 66% of hunters fail to wear any type of safety device during the most dangerous part of the hunt, climbing up and down the tree. Fortunately for Brandon Slodick of Starkville, he wasn't one of those 66% on opening day of bow season this year.
I thought that was it. It's one of those deals where, you start, just the panic sets in and you're like, man, like I said, you're left with nothing but this and the tree.
Shortly before dawn on October the 1st, Brandon was taking the last steps of his climb 25 feet up a pine tree when an improperly fastened strap caused him to lose the bottom portion of his stand.
So when this strap came out, it allowed the two pieces to come apart. So when I pushed down, it allowed the foot platform to slide 7 or 8 foot down below and beyond where I could reach. So I was able to make a few phone calls or whatever to let my wife know, number one, that I needed help, and then where I was. Got to the point where I couldn't hold myself up anymore, trying to figure out what to do, so I had to just let myself drop.
Brandon cites the safety harness he was wearing that morning as the only thing that saved him from a very serious injury or even death. Ironically, it was the first time he had ever attached the device to the tree while actually climbing. Previously, he waited until he was up in the tree and sitting down before securing his harness. As it turns out, this is a method practiced by many other deer hunters who do wear safety devices.
Now that I have a family, I have a wife and 5 children, and As I would climb that tree, that voice of conscience would just kind of be gnawing at me, telling me to attach that safety belt. Because
Brian Parkman, like many other hunters using climbing stands, found the process of having to physically reach and slide the safety belt up the tree while climbing both aggravating and time-consuming. So he did something about it. He invented the DCI.
We named it the DCI, which stands for Don't Chance It. And our motto is, climbing a tree without using a safety belt is a gamble. Don't chance it. As he climbs the tree, the belt moves with him, eliminating the hassle involved with climbing a tree with a safety belt attached. So that as we climb, a person climbs a tree, that person has his safety belt on the tree at all times, and he's safe no matter what portion of the hunt or in the climb he's in.
Parkman says that as a rule, hunters not heeding safety advice simply don't think anything could ever happen to them. He says he used to be the same way until the day he read a survey in Bowhunter magazine stating that 1 in 3 hunters using tree stands will experience a fall in their lifetime. That, he says, opened his eyes.
We all think that it won't happen to us. We think we're Superman, you know. I guess it's kind of an ego thing. We think we won't fall. We think we can grab a hold of a limb, or we think we can get a hold of the tree if we start to fall. But we don't realize that these things happen so fast, and we don't realize that how fast we actually would fall and how hard we would hit the ground.
You never expect it to happen to you. I mean, you hear about it, and it's just one of those, I mean, like with anything, automobile accidents or whatever, you never think it's going to happen to you, but all it takes is one time, one slip, one, you know, misstrap, shift of the stand, and that's it.
It's just like wearing a seatbelt. It's the same with some of these safety procedures with the tree stand. It's very easy to forget about them. It's very easy to be in a hurry and trying to get into the tree before shooting hours begin. But if you do that, you're taking a significant risk.
You know, it's not like that we're fighting some noble cause, that we're going out into the woods and taking on this task. We're deer hunting, you know, and I don't want to belittle our sport, but you know, it is a sport and it's not worth risking our life over. And we can take an extra 3 to 5 minutes and be safe.
From Mississippi State University, I'm Brian Utley reporting.